will now present our next speaker, Glaucio Pessoa, who was born in Recife, Brazil, in a Spiritist family. In his lifelong involvement with the Spiritist movement, he has coordinated mediumship and Spiritist youth educational groups. He holds a master's degree in electrical engineering and currently works and resides with his wife and two children in Atlanta, Georgia. Welcome, Glaucio.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good afternoon, folks. I'd like to, first of all, to thank the organizing committee to provide me with this great opportunity to speak to you this afternoon. Like has been mentioned, I'm going to discuss mediumship in the media. And I'm going to talk not only from a technological standpoint, but also from a historical standpoint as well. First of all, I'd like to start by mentioning the importance of communication, especially communications as it relates to knowledge transfer for human evolution, both physically, intellectually, and spiritually. First of all, knowledge transfer is an interactive process, is a bidirectional process. Plus, it's very important for development, again, intellectual, moral, for a spirit. However, it has to be tailored to the particular moral intellectual levels of development for that particular spiritual community at that particular time. And the spiritual world is very aware of that. And we know that mediumship has always existed from the inception of what we call humankind, and even before, since humankind has existed before as well in other worlds, mediumship has always existed. Something that is also very hard to humans is symbology, is the possibility of represent ideas through symbols. And early humans learned how to use symbols to represent their world, their experiences, nature, both from a physical aspect and a spiritual aspect as well. In the beginning, before humans were able to have all the fascinating types of media that we have today, the two basic types of media were the visual arts and oral tradition. Starting with visual arts, we see a progression, and that progression started what we would call in the beginning primitive art. And primitive art was represented a spiritual connection to nature. And that moves on from that ritualistic connection to nature to a more religious concept in visual arts. In this case, it would be bound by religious principles. And finally, we have what we could call spiritual art. And in this case, it's very broad. It goes all the way from art that is created based on inspiration from the spiritual world all the way to psychopictography. But in this case, there's a free interchange with the spiritual world, meaning the spirits are free to represent themselves in whatever way they want. This is an example of primitive art. This is a drawing of a bison. There is a theory that goes that indicates that whenever we see pictures like this, most likely those are not physical representation of creatures from nature, but spiritual representations that were painted by the so-called shamans in those particular tribes and in a process of trance. Here's an example of religious art. In this case here, we see Muhammad communicating with Archangel Gabriel. Again, we know that an archangel is a designation in some other doctrines for a very high spirit. So this is a mediumic process being represented by art, in this case, through the ideas of Islam. And finally, we have here an example of spiritual art. In this case, the spirit felt free to paint through the medium and represent art as the spirit thought was fit. Next, we can talk about oral tradition. Very important in the beginning, oral tradition, because it is the transmit of information from generation to generation. Could it be from father to son? Could it be from an elder in a tribe or village to the younger generation? And it was very important for us as far as mediumship, because we have, for instance, the case of the prophets who were the emissaries from God, who were mediums who were in contact with the higher spirits, so they could bring teachings to us. But those teachings to us came initially through oral narratives. However, humankind was able to evolve beyond those two media, and then a very important concept was created, which was the written language, which is more precise, provides a better way to be recorded, a better way to be translated, can be copied rather easily, and also is able to represent more complex ideas. And here are some examples of mediumship in literature that we've seen through the ages. Of course, we see the Old Testament, which is extremely rich on historical narratives of mediumship, plus the New Testament. We see everything from Shakespeare, of course, Allan Kardec, Arthur Conan Doyle, all the way from Oscar Wilde. We see narratives related to mediumship. We can also mention the bestsellers by Silvia Gasparetto, who have caught the attention of an audience which is not necessarily spiritist. And we cannot forget the 409 books which were authored through the mediumship of Chico Xavier. Now, in the 19th century, we see an expansion of the written language, not so much literature, but then we see the press and the telegraph, which were much faster and could provide much up-to-date information and could make it available in a global to a global scale. And it was very important because in what is so-called the modern spiritism, the press and the telegraph, they allowed better communication throughout the whole world and better communication between different groups. And so it provided for a better and faster way to exchange information. And a prime example is the case of the Fox sisters, because we see for the first time in history that mediums can become celebrities, and we see what a great impact it had in the inception of modern spiritism. These are some of the prominent newspapers in the 19th century. We can just mention Banner of Light in Boston, also the Revue Spiritée, Spiritée in France. I don't have it here in the list, but we also have Reformador in Brazil that was also created around that time, and Revista Espírita in Brazil as well. Now, we also see in the late 19th century, we see the creation of the radio also allowed better possibilities for communication exchange of ideas, because through airwaves it was easier, it was much faster to reach not only a selected group of people, but whole masses. And the interesting point about radio is that it is still a very important media nowadays. And even with IP technology has provided a true revival of the radio. And now we can have access to radio stations from different parts of the world. Spiritist radio stations, for instance, in Brazil, can be listened here in the U.S. through IP technology. Television can be considered an enhancement of the radio. In this case, it provides better power of persuasion because it uses not only audio, an audio stimuli, but also an audio a visual as well. So that combination makes it more persuasive, more powerful. And an interesting point about television is that it has helped so much bringing spirituality to the masses, and also helped bring down some barriers and some of the prejudice and fear against mediumship in the spiritual world. So we see here some series, Ghost Whispers. This particular series here, Othersiders, believe it or not, is a series for children that deal with research of mediumic phenomena. At this point, I'd like to share a video with you. Believe it or not, is a cartoon. It's an adventure. It's a Batman cartoon, believe it or not. And in this particular case, look at what Batman's going to do. Holy Perry Spirit, Batman has just done a spirit projection. So in this particular case, it's a very interesting example because it is not a spiritism video, it's a cartoon. And in this case, we see that Batman was, what he did as one of his solutions was to do a spiritual projection. And in the whole story, he does get in touch with a spirit who is a lower spirit. It's not a bad spirit, but it's a lower spirit. And interesting thing is that in this particular example, the whole adventure happens in the spiritual world, believe it or not. So there are a lot of gems like this in the media that we can find that were not only produced by spirit, not necessarily spiritist producers, but are so related to the spiritual world. We see also here motion pictures. Throughout these, for several years, cinema has provided incredible movies, blockbusters, where all the greatest effects that money can buy. And those movies deal a lot with themes like life after death, reincarnation, and mediumship. And also, it's so interesting that you see in movies like that, we see this incredible combination of all kinds of thrills, romance, action, whatever you want to add. But interesting that they serve as a way to inculcate in the minds of the masses the way that the spiritual world affects our lives in most times in such subtle ways. So we see here a couple of examples. I'd like to definitely mention Chico Xavier in Brazil, which as of now is the biggest bestseller in Brazil, I'm sorry, blockbuster in Brazil, that is of the Brazilian cinematography. This year also, there's going to be, in Brazil, they're going to release the movie Nosolar, based on the book by the same name. Internet. The internet was created with a major goal to exchange information. It is very, very, very fast. It has a great repository of all kinds of information, especially and particularly information about mediumship. A great media repository also that deals with different lectures about mediumships and different spiritual topics. Social networks have developed, and over the past 2 or 3 years, they have overcome even email as part of a means to communicate and exchange information between different groups, and in this case, spiritual groups. And what we see trends of miniaturization and mobility, and what those do is they bring all this power of the internet onto someone's hand or someone's lap, depending on the kind of device that is being used. Believe it or not, in the world of game, there have been references also through several years to the spiritual world. Now, even though video games usually don't focus on those aspects, it is funny that it is not uncommon to see mediumship being thrown in as an added feature. And sometimes there are some games in which there is a very predominant spiritualistic theme. These are just some examples. The first two games, believe it or not, are shooter games, are games in which the player goes around shooting people. I'll mention very quickly, because the light is already on, that in the first game, there's a section in which the main character gets to see, has a near-death experience, and gets to see all the other characters, the poor characters, has shot before in the spiritual world. Very interesting. This is a little excerpt. Believe it or not, this is a children's game. It's online. It's a puzzle game, and the objective of the puzzle is to bring the spirit back of the little character here, who is, even though it's a child, but he's a medium. So, you know, it's amazing because this is not even it's not a spiritual producer, but, you know, we can see, again, just like in the movies and in TV series, we can see examples like this. Some final notes here. The spiritual world has always, like I mentioned before, used the most appropriate means to reach and instruct mankind. And resources have been employed based on the level of technological and intellectual and moral advancement. And however, the objective is not to convert mankind to a particular doctrine, but is actually to inculcate the importance of the spiritual world in our lives. However, Kardec said something, wrote something very interesting in the medium's book. He mentioned that, "Address yourselves to the heart. It is thus that you will make converts worth gaining." And that's in part 2 of chapter 5. And pretty much the bottom line is, no matter what kind of medium or phenomena we use, the bottom line, it is our moral conduct. Because our moral behavior is still the best medium to show others the positive impact of the spiritual knowledge to human lives. Thanks so much for your time.